Alright, so hey guys, how's it doing? This is Rock Lee. Today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different today. I'm going to be doing Final Fantasy Heavenly Sword. I'm just kidding, it's Heaven Sword. But not really the DLC, but this is a new type of game and I wanted to test it out because I've been playing it a lot. And I mean, if you're going to be part of my lives, you're going to be playing this game with me. So today I am joined with my good buddy old pal Maria Inez. Check her out on YouTube. She sings a lot. Doesn't really upload any games. I'm just kidding. But yeah, check her out. She's fun. And take it from here. There are multiple skills that you can do in this game, such as like blacksmithing, armoring, and there are other stuff like there's a thing. Okay, so there's a set bar list. Let me find it real quick. No, that's not it. Character. All right, so there's a set list of classes. And you can do, okay, so here's some right there. Here's Discipline of War. There's Gladiator. How do you say it? Pugilist? Pugilist?
Pugilist.
Pugilist. Marauder, Lancer, Archer, and Rogue. Those are the disciplines of war. Those are like your melee, you know, go in with a weapon. Then there's Discipline of Magic, Conjurer, which, you know, just your basic, you know, summoning stuff like that or whatever. I have no idea what this is. I'll go it's the T one. What is that one, Marie?
I don't know.
But then there's the Arcana. But anyways, I'm gonna skip that stuff because I have no idea what that is. This stuff down here, I'm relatively new with the game, so I have no idea what it is. But this on the hand, the Disciples of Hand, this is the stuff we're talking about today. And there's Carpenter, Blacksmith, Armorer, Goldsmith, Leatherworker, Weaver, Alchemist, Culinarian. And then down here you have Disciples of the Land, Miner, Botanist, and Fisher. And as you see, I'm kind of a god at Fisher. I'm rank 12 already. Because, you know, I don't know what it is about the game, just throwing your pole, throwing your cast out, and just waiting for that fish just to grab it. But,
You gotta take your shirt off first, though.
yes, I do, in fact. I mean, I feel like that's what a fisherman would do in the sun, you know, get that tan going. So every 5 levels in your guild, see how I'm down there? I'm a culinary guild 5. I can't really point down at the screen. Maybe I'll add an overlay to, like, show you guys. But I am a level 5 culinarian, and for those that don't know what that is just a fancy word for chef. So yes, I'm basically a cook. And at level 5, I get to do a quest line, and you could see it at the right side. If you look at the right side below the big circle where my map is, there's a bunch of set quests. And the second one, it says treat to trout. So I'm going to be delivering a grilled trout to Ingham or whatever. That is my guild master. That is this big Frankenstein looking mother. Effort, I don't know. I don't really want to cuss in front of you guys because I like you guys. But that guy up there, that is my guild master, and I have to find. He is testing me with the ability, with the power of cooking. Now, basically, what I want to do is, I have to go to my logs, and it is R2. I'll hold R2, and I'll go to crafting logs, and I'll look and see what I need to make a treat of trout, a grilled trout. So let's look. All right, so there's recipes 1 through 5, and then there's 6 through 10. I don't think he'd make me do 6 through 10, but I'll go ahead and look through there and see if it's there. Okay, no. Oh, Maria, I can make a jack-o'-lantern.
What?
I know, right? Oh, and we just missed Halloween. Damn it. Whatever.
Dang it.
Okay, so grilled trout. I need a princess trout, which I have 3, and I need table salts. So this should be pretty easy. Let's see if she owns some table salts for me. I don't know how to grind my own table salt. Ah, dude, I just can't speak English today. I don't know how to grind my own table salt, so I'm just gonna cheat and buy the materials. Oh god, she doesn't have any. All right, well, she does have some. Wait, rock salts? Does that count? Let me check. Just no, I guess table salts. All right. So it doesn't look like. Hopefully, let me relook. Somebody's probably screaming at the screen right now. It's like, dude, it's right there, and I'm not just seeing it. So let me check one more time. All right, so she doesn't have any table salts. So I will be right back once I find some. And we are back. I am actually an idiot. So it turns out you can actually craft your own table salt. So let me go ahead and show you what the materials I need. So it's literally the first thing on the thing. All right, table salt. So I'll need rock salt, which I have 30. If you don't see it, there's NQ, which I'm assuming is, you know, kind of a lesser quality, and then there's HQ, which I'm assuming is high quality. I don't know. I'm new at this game, so give me a break. But we're gonna need some distilled water, and if I'm not mistaken, the chick over at the Culinary Guild was selling some distilled water. So I'm going to be heading there right now. All right, so I'm going down the list, guys, and please have distilled water. Okay, she has distilled water. Okay, so she has distilled water with 30 for 3 gil each. So I'm going to go and buy, I'm not going to buy 99. Sorry about the ticking in your head. I'm going to buy, let's go with 32. That's a weird number. Alright, so now we have our distilled water, and we have everything we need to make table salt. So, boom, boom. I'm gonna pull out my little skillet. Oh, I'm gonna do this new ability where I put a basic touch. Basically, it raises the quality, and I'm assuming that makes it... maybe to where you can sell this stuff better, maybe it gives you a little bit more experience. Okay, I see. See the 100% there? It is at normal quality right now. Okay, so that's what NQ stands for. But I can chance it and make it to high quality. But that seems more like a higher level kind of thing. So I don't think I'm going to be doing that right away. Okay, so my high quality percentage is 3%. Okay, I think I'm going to assume this. You see the number down at the bottom? Right now it says 37 out of 312. And what I think that means is if I can get my quality to 312 out of 312, then my HQ percentage will be 100%. So right now it's at 3%. So I have a 3% chance of making this a high quality dish, which it's table salt, so I don't really care that much. But you have to be careful too, because you have a process bar up there, which every time you try to give it your basic touch, the durability of your food will decrease. So there's a chance of your food like blowing up in your face, and we don't want that. But we have the ingredients we want right now, so I have table salt. And I have a queen fish, so let's go ahead and make our grilled trout.
Ooh.
All right, so we're at 10%. All right, now we're at 60%. And oh, it busted! No. Oh wait. All right, now okay, cool. I have another trout. Whew. Okay, one more time. And we have made our grilled trout. Yay! Alright, so now we can complete our quest. Hello. What is it? What is it? A grilled trout for me? Well, yes, I am quite fond of the dish. But what have I done to deserve this? For just being freaking fantastic, bro. Oh, look, I made three trout. I've made three grilled trout, so I'm only handing him one. So I'll have two. Cool. The guildmaster thought it would cheer me up, you say? Well, meaning that, though he may be, food is not the solution to everyone's woe. But come, let us see your handiwork. It is my duty as your senior to give you counsel, after all. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. The last guild I was in, I had this dude. He's kind of a douche. Surely not. You made this? Truly, the aroma. It's delightful. And the skin, even though it's slightly charred, just as it should be. 12 saved me. The thought of a silking my teeth into crisp layer, oh, tasting the tender fresh beneath. Oh, I'm not very good at giving voices, but oh, beg your pardon. As I said, this is quite impressive. In fact, I doubt even the guildmaster would be able to fault it. Trust me, I know. God, I like this guy. He sounds so proper. But I don't understand it. You've been here scarcely long enough to learn syrup making, yet you're capable of this? Do you know how long it took me to achieve this same? 6 bleeding moons! That's 6 days for the people who don't play Final Fantasy. Gods, I am so utterly devoid of talent. No, I will not. I'm going a completely different voice for this guy. I'm sorry, let me rethink. No, I will not be outdone by a mere novice. I refuse to be outdone. My apologies. Thank you for the trout, and I would have accepted this knife. Wait. And would you have... I would have you accept this knife from me. Use it to conjunction with your skillet and... Ooh, am I learning a new skill? And cooking experience will be much enhanced. Do not mistake it for a gift. It is... Actually, I should give him a French accent. Do not I don't have one. I need... Do it, Marie. Do not... do not mistake this for a gift. Do that in a French accent.
I can't... I don't have a French accent. I'm a girl.
Do not mistake it for a gift. This is a payment for the trust. Nothing more. Or maybe I can go Australian. Besides, it would give me great... No. No, that's more of a crystal... It would give me a great... No pressure. For to give... You know what? Just finish it off. Get the better of a man who wasn't properly equipped. Now leave me be. I have stock to take. Okay, so certain gear grants bonus to your craftsman control and CP values. CP is like... What is it? There are certain type of crafts. I'm guessing it's craft points, like when you're crafting stuff. I almost said the S word, sorry. And if you notice, whenever I'm making... whenever I don't know if you noticed, but when I was trying to give it the basic touch... I have CP points and they'd go down each one, so I guess I can do a certain amount, but he just gave me a knife, so I think it's going to give me additional CP, and I totally did not just read that down at the bottom. Outfitting yourself with an eye to your current objective will increase the effective of your crafting endeavors. Okay, so I can get fire shards, blah blah blah. Ooh, a culinary knife. Oh, okay, so this is what he gives me. Okay, so I could get a Hampton bandana, which I think I already own. Oh, that gives me a lot of perspective. Or perspective, or whatever. Does it tell me how much I have? Okay, no, I don't I own one of those, so I'm not gonna take that. Gives me that. Okay, so I'm gonna go with the, that is like pants. I don't know how to pronounce it. Let's go with chausses. I don't know. We're gonna get that, because, let's see. I think it raises, does it raise anything? Okay, it raises my control. Okay, so that's cool. So that means things are gonna burst in my face as much. Sweet! So we have completed the quest. And it leveled me up, yay! Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and check out these pants for you guys, and... Ooh, they're white, I can't really see. What, you know, why don't I just take off my shirt? Oh yeah. Alright, but anyways. Huh. So that will do it for this portion of culinary's training. I will be back with the next part. I don't know, we might do a little bit of the main quest. That I could probably restart the main quest with a different character. Perhaps do like an archer guild, like my good buddy old pal Marie, who's been quiet! I'm just kidding.
I'm sorry!
No, it was good having you along for the ride. I don't know, I don't typically bring people into this. You know, sometimes I'll upload a video and you'll hear people in the background, but it's not very often that I have a planned video with somebody in the background, so I like to thank Marie for being here with us. Thank you, Marie.
If it makes you feel better, I was having to do a really weird dance on this quest.
Oh.
So I was kind of distraught because my character was dancing really weirdly. So I was like, I was like,
I bet you didn't have, do you have the festival dance? Is that what you need?
No, I got the ball, it's the ball dance.
Oh, I have that. Oh, I know what you're doing. You must be in the, you're in Olda, right? In that...
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. You should see how he talks to the girl after. It's kind of hilarious.
I was like, oh my god.
But this is just going to be the first part of a three-part series. I'm going to upload... this is just... Okay, so this is going to be a 40-minute long video, or probably an hour. It depends on how long it takes. This video didn't take that long at all. So... After this, there's going to be another part, and then another part after this. So I'll see you guys in the next part. Until then, this is Brock Lee with Marie Inez. See you in the next one. So how are you doing this fine day, Miss Hikari Tenchi?
Oh, I'm doing just fine.
Yeah. Oh, I thought I reckon I catch a big one out there. Yes, I sure do.
Oh. I'm only level 3, so I'll see what I catch.
All right, so... As you can see, me and my good... I just missed a fish. As you can see, me and my friend Marie, she's back at it again. No, I'm just kidding. But we are out fishing. And as you can see, my stat is 12. I'm level 12 right now. Oh, Did you catch something, Marie?
Merle Thor Gobi?
Oh, that's yeah, I know what that is. Yeah, those you'll catch these kind of fish, and once you get to a higher level, you'll start catching like I just got an ocean cloud, which I guess is a type of jellyfish.
Do they have cloud hair?
That'd be kind of funny. I'm just kidding. I see what you did there. But yes, I am at level 12 right now, and right now I'm on the fishing grinds, and my friend, that's Marie over there, Hikari, and she is learning her fishing skills as well. And I think she caught her first fish, which was kelp. What a nerd. But while I'm about to level up, I wanted you guys to see this. Oh, I got a fish on the line. And I missed it because I'm paying attention to you guys. Just kidding. But so basically, every so often, you'll catch a good fish. And what you want to do is, or what happens basically, what that means is, you'll have a fishing log, and I'll show you right after I reel this in. Sorry, I'm not the best at explaining these stuff because because I have about a million things going on right now. But right here, you have your fishing log, and it shows you basically where you can catch your fish. Oh no, I cussed! Anyways, so you have your fishing log, and right there at the bottom, it tells you everything you can catch here. So as you can see, I've caught a Moby, kelp, shrimp, cloudfish, a trout, I think they called it a butterfly fish, and then I have some anchovies. But down there at the right too, you see that there are two types of fish I haven't quite discovered yet, and maybe that's a higher level or perhaps. And then right here, I haven't caught anything in the black shroud or thanalan. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. I have yet to be there, haven't been there. But basically, that's just a brief explanation of what it is. It will keep your login of basically what you can catch out there and what you haven't caught out there. So that's pretty cool. And you have your fish guide, and this just shows you how many fish I have caught. So I've caught, here's the kelp that Marie caught. It is a level 4 type fish, so she actually caught that. If she catches more of those, she'll level up faster, so that's actually pretty good for her.
Yay!
Then you have the crayfish, which that is, if you see it down there, it is a crafting material. It'll tell you if it's a crafting material also, which I'm assuming each fish is, except for this fish right on cue. This is a chub. I think it's a type of shark, actually. I'm not just spitballing here, but it looks kind of like a shark. Then right here, you have the goby. I don't know what it's called, but this is what Marie just caught. It's a level 3 fish, so that's what she needs to catch at this low level, because I think you're what, level 2, Marie?
I'm level 3, about to be level 4.
Hey, alright then. She is level 3, so I should give her a little bit more credit. Sorry, Marie.
It's okay.
Now this right here, this Lomisan, I don't know, anchovy, you want to catch about a million of these, because this is the best way to level up your culinary skills. Some skills will actually go hand in hand, like the botanist skill will probably go pretty good with culinary. And of course, mining and blacksmithing and armor will probably go together as well. I have yet to do those, but once I decide to do those, I'll make a video on that, and I'll try to help with any way I can. Then you have the striped goby. The striped goby is a type of fish that has it's a type of fish, so don't worry about that. I'm just kidding. I could read this right here. A brightly striped fish. A freshwater fish. Wait, this is freshwater? Lies. But I probably haven't caught this fish here anyway, so what am I talking about? Then you have your finger shrimp. Ooh, I like the sound of that. Then you have your white coral, your princess trout, which that is actually going to be on a quest line. Once you're probably about to do it right now, Marie, if you're level 3, the princess trout, and I'll show you where that is in a little bit. Then you have your ocean cloud, which I just caught here, your harboring herring. That is actually what I meant, not the anchovy. You want these herrings, because the herrings are what you'll use to level up your culinary skills when you decide to go hand in hand, when you're a complete strategist like me. Then you have the papara, I guess that's what it is, papyra. That actually sounds kind of like a fruit. I think that's a papaya is what I'm thinking of. Then you have the Golgion. These are just fish that I've discovered. If you want to pause this and read what they all have, I just don't want, you can do that. I don't want to spend doing all this, but these are a type of fish that you can find in different areas. Then you have so much more. Like, look at this. Holy hell, we have over 20 freaking slots, 19 slots of fish to find. So we are just starting. We had just scratched the surface of fishing. But So basically what I'm gonna do is, guys, I'm basically showing you this part right now, and I will see you guys when I'm level 15. Until then, or actually no, I'll see you guys when I'm helping Marie catch the princess trout. But until then, I'll see you in the next
Yay!
part. Well, actually, this, you know what? I won't even give it a next part. I'll just see you then. Later, guys. What is your quest line?
Well, I'm about to finish my first fishing rod thing. I've been out here fishing and I could have turned this in.
Don't you have to catch a certain amount of fish?
Yeah, I caught five of the lemons and anchovies.
Gotcha. All right, let me know when she tells you to go catch the princess trout. Spoilers, by the way.
Okay. This is what she says. Here, Chovy Chovy. Here, Chovy Chovy. Fair flock of feisty fish you've got, kitty guppy.
One
She's
second,
so
Marie.
adorable.
One second, Marie.
Okay.
Oh, level 13! Just two more levels, guys, and I will be able to show you the next part of the quest. That is all. And we are back. Sorry, folks. Marie actually just got to level 5, so she is going to read the next part of her quest, and we are going to help her with her quest and help her find the Princess Trout and see if we can catch one too. So take it
Yeah.
away, Marie.
Sisifu has a trial in mind for you. Okay. I smell that you haven't been neglecting your duties. Ooh, God. A commendable attitude. No one's ever gotten worse at anything by practicing. No one I know, at least. Then again, you can't expect the same old tricks to work with new big fish. Big ones don't grow to be that way, chasing everything that wiggles on a hook. To catch the fish you want, you must first know what the fish wants. Only once their prize is at stake, you can tantalize and tempt your prey to taste the forbidden tackle. Anchovies may be willing to settle for lugworms, but harbor herring have a discerning palate that prefers pill bugs. Blech. But don't take my word for it. Go and see for yourself. Pick up some pill bugs from Sun Hill over in West Hawker's Alley and use them to catch three local harbor herring, like anchovies. They can be caught right outside. In case you've a mind to return to your previous spot, you should know that fish aren't as foolish as most might think. Keep casting your line in the same waters, and you'll find fewer folk will take the bait. Alrighty. So this is the harbor herring one.
Harbor herring. Oh, it's not Princess Trout?
So maybe I need to do this one first. Because she's got a red icon above her head again.
Well,
I just need to know where to go get pill bugs, though.
Oh, pill bugs? Yeah. All right. So maybe it's not the Princess Trout, but I will help you find pill bugs because I'm actually running low too.
Recording real quick while we figure out where this place is at. Okay, I know of where it's at. I just can't remember if it's in Western Genosha or Western, or I guess it's in Western, so it's just keep going. I heard a guy from just this random guy. That's the only place that I know of that he sells it. And Chuck is the one who found out where it was. Shiza, we gotta go the other way. Actually, let's go ahead and take this over to where? Limosa Plaza. And go left once you're left with the crystal. I'm ahead of you. It is getting dark. You better stay safe, close to me so I can protect you. Oh my god. Middle of Russia. Is this middle of Russia? That's okay. It's this way anyway. You see that tower in front of us, the building? Yeah, that's where it's at. Hey, it's my name. Oh my god, it's a trap! I'm running!
Is that a crystal up there? Have I done that crystal yet? Alright, so this guy is who sells it. And go to tools. Then go down to the very
Okay.
bottom.
Oh, pill bugs. Do I need to go ahead and grab some crayfish too?
sure. All right, we are back with some more Fishing Simulator 2016. And just right now, we are trying to get Marie some, what was it again, Marie? Some,
herring.
Yeah, we are trying to find some herring for Marie. I think you need how many? Harbor herring. I just caught one, actually.
I need three.
All right, so she needs
three. I need to equip the pill bug. There we go.
There you go. Nice. And we need her to get her three, and then she will go to her next quest, which she might actually have to be level 10 in order to the Princess Trout, so that was just me being mistaken. But once we help her find some harbor herrings, I will see you guys when I'm level 15, which, as you can see, I'm kind of close, but not really. So, Marie, how many fish do you have?
I don't have any herring yet.
I'm new to this whole fishing thing. I might be level 13, but that is because of straight grind, and I don't pretend that I know exactly what I'm doing here. So I'm kind of just playing things by the ear. So if you see me struggling, please help me. Comment something down below and help me with this game.
I got a herring.
Nice. So you need only two more?
Dos más.
I just caught the condition of your weathered choker. Wait, how is the condition of my choker being damaged when we're fishing? I will see you guys in a little bit. Once Marie catches her third herring, I'll be right with you. So, until then, take it easy. So Marie has finally caught her third harbor herring, so we are going to go back to the fish guild, and she is going to turn in her quest, and I think you'll get a new fishing pole or something, but I think you have to be level 8 to actually use it, though. And that is the fishing pole I am currently using. Alright, so we're going to warp speed to the fishing guild. So, see you guys in a bit.
Woo!
Alright, so Marie
quest
just...
complete.
So Marie just created, just completed this quest. Basically, now all she has to do is to get to level 10, and she'll get the next part of the quest, which that will be the princess quest, I think. But until then, guys, this is, this is not until then. We are still going to continue to go, because I still got to get to 15. Sorry about that, guys, so I'll see you when I'm level 15. Ciao. And with that fish, I'm level 14. Just one more level to go, guys. I can't wait. I can't wait until we're reunited. I'll see you. There we go. Alright, guys, I just leveled up to the Covenant level 15. You know what that means? I will see you guys at the Fishing Guild. Hey, guys, we are back, and I am level 15, and I'm ready to continue the next part of this quest. So let's see what it is. Hello, Sisipu. What? Oh, dang, that's a lot of experience right there you got, little Missy. Alright, she could use some help. A helping hand with an unexpected order. I've been thinking, Teshi, now that you can catch more fish than you can eat, it's time you've learned a little bit about the art of fishmongering. Normally, customers purchase fish that have already been caught, but a certain sailor has a penchant for freshness. Fortunately, the fisherman who usually fills his order to have all, somewhat ironically, has gone fishing, and so I turn to you, Teshi. I hope you can talk to Chuchurun over there and at least listen to him. Jesus, these names. Alright, little guy. Oh wait, you're a bad guy, sort of. I guess you're a good one? I don't know. Bubba the sailor sails the seas. You're the fisherman. Fish the fish. Look out as I look out. Spots in the water. Jumps silver. Oh my god, how do you speak? Wish to taste silverfish taste. I'm just going to call him CC. CC pays good silver if you fish 5 good silverfish. Okay, so it appears I have to catch... Wait. Oh no, I gotta speak to this girl. Alright, so tell me what I gotta do now. Well, Cece has a way with words, doesn't he? Unfortunately, his way appears to be repeating the word silverfish. Only the most experienced fishermen would be able to decipher that nonsense. This sounds for a job for the Wawalago. Since I'm busy doing this job, rest assured that if he may lack in sense, he more makes up for in nonsense. Okay, well. Huh. Alright, so I will speak with Wawalala, and I will see you guys in a bit. Alright, so it turns out that he was literally right next door, so I didn't have to go finding anyone. Hey, you. Said, what is it, Sybil, to sneak up and scare your seniors? I suddenly suspected whatever, we'll call her SP, sent you to slit my stomach. That woman, well aware of my weakness, is going to shout about the way I shove down shrimp. She should know better than to leave them showing on the shelf. Or is that not why you're here? Setting the table setting aside, I bet you shells to shellfish, I know what the whatever. What do you say? Stop speaking weird. Daggers don't let themselves to a Lamisan like likely, but the settlers of the Southerly Isles I can't read this, man. You can find them by the Brewer's Beacon, snarling one of its slippery sleighs for a starter, but flitting flick of its fist for a fisherman with a gull eyes like you have. Jesus Christ. Now, daggering the drawn to decoys that dangle, so yourself a favor and fetch some rat tails for them to flash their fins at. You have, for some reason, a habit of saying the same letter. You say words that start with the same letter a lot. You douche. Anyways. So now, deliver Navigator's daggers to CC. Now how the flying... What? I'll be right back once I figure this out. Alright, I'm back, guys. How are you doing? Right now, I'm in a weird area. Basically, all I was doing was buying some rat tail bait. I looked up on some forums and said that rat tail bait is what will get these silver fists to drop. The next place I need to go to, though, is a place called the Brewer's Beacon, and it says that it has its longitude and latitude is 30 by 30, so I'm going to have to find to where it says X is 30, and then Y is 30. So, is that it? That might be it right there. Yes. So let's go here. And we're just going to be trucking along. This way. Alright, so this looks like it might be Brewer's Beacon. Hopefully I don't accidentally aggro one of these. Of course I do. I'm going to be running around for a little bit. Hopefully that the guy doesn't come after me. So, yeah! Alright, so this must be it. First of all, let me put on the right kind of bait. There it is. Ah! Here it is right here. Alright, now let's let her rip. So I don't know how you guys like fishing in real life, but it is. If it was anywhere as fast as it is in this game, it would be so much fun. Oh, looks like we got a bite. Alright, let's just reel that on in. And we got a Navigator's Dagger. Nice. Alright, we're just going to need a few more of these. The fish got away! And it appears we have finally gotten the last fish we need. 17 inches, my god, that's a big fish. Alright, so now that we have this fish in our inventory, we are going to hop on over back to the fishing guild. I think that's what we're doing next. Yes, we are. All right, so Lima Limazona. I don't know how to pronounce. Real quick, guys. So this lady right here is dressed up just like Lightning from Final Fantasy 13, and she has been dancing there for at least the last 5 hours. Like every time I appear here, she is still there. I don't know if she's an NPC or if she's real. In fact, you know what? Let's tip her real quick. Let's see if she accepts my. She's level 60. All right. So. I'm gonna tip her. I'm gonna tip her 500. Just for sitting there all day. Let's see if she accepts it. Alright, I guess she's not going to accept it. Oh well, that would have been kind of cool if she was like, hey, and took it. But she has been sitting there for a lot of day, and that is a lot of effort, and she deserves some kind of reward. But as we appear at the fishing market, oh, it appears he's. Yep, oh yeah, I remember this guy. This is a guy who I cannot understand. Hold on, here we go. You fish, catch 5 fish, catch 4 choo-choo rune. Yep, here's your flying fish. The shiny, the shine, the smelly smell. Cannot wait to tasty taste taste. Well, it looks like we found the fish you were after. You find. Maybe chuchu seasons with seasons, or smoke with smoke. Maybe grill on grill. Maybe cook option for cook. Maybe you're certainly put up a great deal of thought into this. Ha 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 ha. Chichu rune gifted to feast on feast gift. Best Chichu rune regard you with Chichu rune's best regards. We were always grateful. We're always grateful for your patronage, Chichu rune. Please see him out and return here afterwards, Teshi. We have more to discuss. Aw, he's so happy. I feel better now. That was totally worth all that effort to get to level 15. Phew! I'm glad you were here to handle that sudden request. So many of these freeloading fishermen can't be bothered to stay ashore for more than a day at a time. You, on the other hand, you have proven far more reliable. I can't think of at least one Kwee-kwee who'd agree. Now that you've seen how rewarding fishmongering can be, I hope you take the initiative to try it yourself. Gathering perception. I'm gonna take that. Definitely worth. Alright! Let me see what this chest piece looks like real quick. Was this it? Yeah, I think this is it. That looks a little silly, but hey man. Whatever gets all that skills up, you know what I'm saying? Well, this has been Rock Lee. Thank you so much for being a part of this part. It was going to be part three, but it took a long time. So, part one, part two of a very short culinary basic startup, and my third or fourth mission as far as a fisherman. But I appreciate you guys sticking with me. I will try to continue an episode sometime later this week. Until then, I will see you guys in the next episode. See ya.